Hello and welcome to a new review here on my channel. Today I want to test something out. I'm a very visual person that sees a lot of art in video games. For me, and thanks to the devs, I really enjoy the digital art and the interactive worlds they've created. For myself, I capture a lot of beautiful and stunning moments with screenshots. Today I want to create a review only with screenshots. For that, I will show no video footage, but only pictures and informations about the game. The consideration is that I want to let scenes open to you to enjoy for yourself and make your own picture, but also tell you about my personal perception on the title. Today's game is nothing less than the highly anticipated game Robocop Rogue City. It was actually released on November the 2nd and came out for PC and consoles. The game was created with the Unreal Engine 5 and looks amazing, not only on the screens but also in motion. Tayen, the developers, decided to deliver the 80s and 90s fans another great franchise. The devs had of course some flaws with their previous projects, and also Robocop is no flawless presentation. But I have to admit that I admire their increase in skill. Robocop is not only their best game, no, it's also the best Robocop game ever made. This project is a true fan service, which they had also delivered with the Terminator game. Tayen really put a lot of effort into making this. And despite their limits as a smaller developer, they have achieved some extraordinary goals. I've completed the game in about 28 hours with a lot of exploration and without the HUD activated to get soaked into the virtual Detroit. Be aware that this game is just a single player experience. For myself, that's not a big problem, and as a fan of single player games, I appreciate their work so far. Without telling you too much about the plot, it's well written and let you jump into the events happening after Robocop 1 and 2 ongoing to part 3. The devs managed to create an atmospheric timeline after and before the movies, which perfectly fits into the franchise, to complement the world about Alex Murphy, aka Robocop. Therefore, Peter Weller, the original Robocop actor, was involved and gave Murphy his characteristic voice. But there are also a lot of old and new characters in the game which harmonize together. As Alex Murphy, you will witness and explore the story in a first-person view while you're playing. Also garnished cutscenes which look good but could be better in case of the animations and facial expressions. First, we will have a look on the obvious and undeniable, the beauty of the game when it comes to graphics. The graphics are phenomenal and gorgeous almost all of the time. The texture quality is incredibly sharp for most of the objects, but I also witnessed some not over the top textures and even some delayed loaded ones. I've played a game with max settings and without the regular upscaling methods in full screen. For most of the time, the game runs super fluently on my setup, and I only had one crash after about 7 hours, where the screen froze once. To be honest, I've expected more crashes due to the new engine and my personal experiences with some Unreal Engine games. As mentioned before, the game runs good, but is also hungry on resources. Keep that in mind. In a few scenes, I had even some slowdowns due to the massive action on the screen, but the FPS just drops a bit. Compared to other games, it was nothing at all to get angry with. Detroit itself looks fantastic in this game, and the devs perfectly captured the dark and gritty look of the first movie. I don't know any game which looks so close to the movie template. They totally nailed it with Rogue City, and it doesn't matter if you're out at night or in broad daylight. In some parts, and in combination with Robocop's view, it just looks real. This also applies to the buildings and interiors. The lighting is also impressive and shows the strength of the Unreal Engine 5. But of course, not everything is optically beautiful. When it comes to the animations and facial expressions, the game sadly lacks a lot compared to others. While the eye movement is brilliant in this title and gives the characters virtual life, the mouth movements looks weird and oddly sometimes and doesn't feel natural at all. Sure, these are not AAA devs, but they've also managed to get the licenses of three huge brands like Rambo, Terminator and Robocop. I think the problem with the animations is above all because the graphics are so insanely good that the gamers will recognize these flaws much more than in other games which might not be looking so good. If they would have managed to create a quality like the mocap team of NetherRealm Studio, this would be without a doubt one of the most impressive games ever. But unfortunately, they didn't, and so the game gets you out of the immersion sometimes or sprays a bit of a trash factor. I even had to laugh involuntarily from time to time. And although these are by far not the best animations, I need to add that they did a good job with the micro movement and body language. The characters will move all the time and don't stay static and still like in other games. The audio is good too, but also with a good and a bad side. The weapon sounds differ vastly from each other. While the Auto 9, Robocop's handgun, manufactured by Beretta back in the day, sounds brilliant and has a lot of punch, like some other weapons too. But there are also guns, especially the assault rifles and machine gun, which sound like they were from a 2000s game, using generic weapon sounds. I also witnessed a few acoustic failures with sound samples. The well-chosen music, which adds a lot to the Robocop atmosphere, also had some flaws. Sometimes it just stopped the track or it wasn't any background music at all. That's my next critic here. In some scenarios there is no music at all, which is not bad in a lot of games if they have good ambient sounds and noises. But I think Detroit is too quiet here from time to time. It could be louder and you should hear more traffic, not only on the road. The characteristic theme is included and gives you the Robocop vibes you need. There are also a few good other tracks which add atmosphere but also repeat themselves. The voices reach from over the top film worthy to "Are you serious?" While Robocop and almost all of the important characters sound phenomenal and they did a great job in voicing them, some side characters sound completely weird and I had to laugh more often than I wanted. This is okay for a laugh, but more likely not on purpose. I've played the game with an Xbox pad and the standard configuration is great. The gunplay feels good most of the time, but you will also witness that the game is not as impressive like Ready or Not, for example, which gives you a much better weapon feedback and bullet impact. I like the movement of Murphy, a real and slow tank, but don't worry, the devs implemented a sprint button and even a dash feature. So you feel like a tank, but not as slow as the real Robocop. Good decision from Tayan. This game also contains physics and destruction. The levels can be part-time destroyed and this looks quite impressive. There's a lot of debris and particles flying around everywhere, but also mentioned without weight to it. That also counts for the ragdoll effect. While they are mostly stunning and good looking, sometimes they will even put you a smile on your face from time to time. Enemies fly into the air like a New Year's rocket without any inertia or the limbs will become extra flexible. The blood and gore is fantastic if you are a gorehound like me and I really enjoyed the visual feedback of the hits. You will also be able to dismember your foes in different ways. The headshots are extremely gory and a lot of brain tissues will fly around and even stick on the surfaces. What I can understand, but also didn't like, is the fact that the bullet holes and damage on the surrounding, the wounds, blood and gore, and even most of the bodies will disappear over time. In many cases, it's okay, because you move on. But if you went into a room, splatter the punks and the cutscene starts, you will get pushed out of the immersion, because the gore and parts, even the bodies, will visibly disappear out of the scene. Now about the fan service. This is obviously one of the greatest fan services ever made in a game. There's a lot of background information from the Robocop franchise and it manifests in different ways. Even it's already shown in the massive details like the advertising, or in other cases, like a man sitting on a slide on a playground and pipes the theme melody of Paul Verhoeven's Robocop 1, created by the famous composer Basil Poledouris. Also, the devs implemented a lot of faces from the franchise with worth recognition. The citizens also talk about persons and incidents from the franchise. I also admired that they had rewritten some of the famous phrases from the movies and put them perfectly fitting into their work. Good job. This is really a true fan service. As a fan, you will really get what you want in form of variety. Now about the playtime and structure. Besides the main plot, you got a lot of detective work to do, and I had to think on the famous Simpsons sketch about the cyborganizer, where a Robocop-like figure had to do the office work. Here in the game you are a detective, and this is great. You are also be able to pursue crimes and uphold the law above the main missions. If you go on with all the extra side quests, you will have a lot of playtime. If you want it harder and really be a detective, I suggest to turn off the HUD completely so you have to search the clues by your own. This will definitely take some time, and you need to keep an eye open for the clues and hints. For example, to go to a person which is smoking on the gas station near to his car. You can decide if you give a ticket or only a warning. With a warning, you gain the public trust, which is also a directive, and the citizens will be more friendly to you. For example, I've captured a sprayer while tagging a wall and gave him a ticket. He promised me revenge, and a few missions later he did this. Even you have the choice of different answers, it doesn't weigh too heavy on the progress. It's nice, but it could be more deep in my opinion, and should give you more relevant consequences. After every main mission, you have a meeting with your OCP psychologist to talk about your improvement in an evaluation session. I really like this feature. You will also be able to level up Robocop and give him new abilities. The points for the improvements are granted by solving tasks, doing your duty, and completing the missions. You can also upgrade your weapon with different perks, where you have the opportunity to go full auto on the Auto 9, or even add more gore effects to the usage of the weapon. Rogue City is no open world game like GTA, but more like a small Souls game, with variable sections you enter. The Detroit Police Department is your main hub, and then you go out for the missions in different districts. The scenarios give you a variety in time, and you will also encounter more and more spots on the map. The indoor parts can be compared with the dungeons. And another compliment to the devs for recreating so many spots from the movie, you will definitely recognize and enjoy them in the game. Overall, Robocop Rogue City is a fantastic fan game, and you will see the effort Theon put into this project. This is from fans for the fans, and you have to admire that. I know this game is far from perfect, but I can really see their improvement in skills compared to their previous works. And so I stay excited for their next project. I could imagine a Robocop vs. Terminator crossover like in the good old days, or maybe my highest hopes are that they will give us a Predator game. But back to Robocop, you get fantastic visuals with a good sound and proper gameplay, the weapons are fun, and the gore is great. So if you are a Robocop fan and looking for a game which delivers you the spirit of the originally Verhoeven movie and even the Kirschner one, you have to buy this game. You will encounter funny situations and a few bugs and disagreements, but you will also get some excellent entertainment with these titles. I'd buy that for a dollar, so wait for the sale. Thanks for watching, and see you next time, and don't forget, bitches leave.